بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسول الكريم. So last lesson we discussed this ibara. So we're not going to go through again. I just want to run through with you on like a summarize the musnad and the musnad ilay. So if you look at the footnotes of the print our copy, you will see that you have one side you have all the mahkum alay, which is also known as the musnad ilay, and the other side you have all the mahkum bihi, also known as the musnad. We can discuss those individually. So again, the musnad ilay is what you call in English what? Subject, the thing you are discussing. And the musnad or the mahkum bihi is the information that you're giving about the mahkum alay or the musnad ilay. It's a subject, you got the predicate and information, but that won't be correct because it's slightly different. But this is a subject and this is the other additional part. So if you look at it here, these come together. Because if you have a fa'il and a fa'il, or you have a fa'il majhul and na'ibul fa'il, so what's the information? What's the subject? The fa'il. Or the na'ibul fa'il. Or, and what's the information? The fa'il. Okay, so for example, look, you have here our standard example. Qatala Dawoodu. Who talking about? Who's the subject? What's the information about him? Qatala. Ghuliba is fa'il majhul. Room. The Romans have been conquered. So who's the subject? A room. That's the musnad ilay. And what's the musnad information? Ghuliba. Got it? Now, ismul fa'il. Ami. Ami is a noun, but it means istajib, accept. So the fa'il is inside. So the ameen is a musnad, and the fa'il that's interpreted inside of it is the musnad ilay. If you have a masdar, and the masdar takes the place of a fa'il. So what happens? Labbaik. So labbaik means what? Well, I am present. So that's also musnad ilay, and the I zameer that is interpreted is the musnad. This is the musnad, and the zameer inside is going to be the musnad ilay. Correct? The mubtada al-muktafi bi marfu'ihi is a musnad, and the file of that becomes a musnad ilay. So for example, raghibun is what? Musnad, and anta is what? Isam is a marfu of this. This becomes a musnad ilay. Correct? Mubtada khabar. Muhammad is a mubtada, that's a khabar. Musnad ilay, and this is the musnad. Isam of kana and akhawatuha and the khabar of kana. So lafzul jalala is the musnad ilay, and aliman is the musnad. You have ism of inna. So lafzul jalala again is the musnad ilay, and wasi'un is the musnad. Right. You got now, let's get again a bit more. Now these examples are a bit less common now. It's becoming more and more rare. If you got dhanna, what does dhanna mean? To think. If you think of somebody as being something, or something as being something else, then Zaydun is not the musnad ilay. What's the musnad ilay? Ad-dars sahlun. So really the real sentence is ad-darsu sahlun. The lesson is easy. And then Zayd thinks of the lesson being easy. This is a musnad ilay, that's a musnad. And it's a quyud. Do you understand? In Zanna. Okay? If you say ara, if a verb has three maf'uls, to show somebody, but this is not you, not discuss it, but I can't find examples of this. You will not have this structure, but just for the argument's sake and for the nahwa purposes, and the balagha probably discuss it. So for example, you have ara to show, ara yuri iratun, to show somebody. So let's say for example, I show you that something is something. Then a something is musnad ilay, and something else is a musnad. For example here, ara al ustadhu at tilmidha at darsa sahlan. The teacher showed the student what? The lesson is easy. This is a musnad ilay, that's a musnad ilay, the quyud. You get it?
If you say that if the teacher showed or they thought, is it not the subject? Though?
It is a subject, but the main information of this sentence is not the ustaz telling, it's this information. That's why you call this a musnad ilay, because the main information is not the teacher showing, but it's this information.
But in the nahwa sense.
Yeah, it is a subject of this. That's why you wouldn't get this structure really. You normally get, you say, ara al ustaz al tilmid anna darasa sahlan. Anna darasa sahlun. Do you understand? Okay? Do you understand?